Hi guys, welcome back. Today is one of those days again where I am going to be making one of my favorite Indian vegetarian main course recipes. And I'm sure it's one of your favorites too, because it is such a popular and classic choice whenever we go to an Indian restaurant or a dhaba. So today we are going to make an easy version of the decadent, delicious, luxurious paneer butter masala at home. It's going to be super simple, super quick and super delicious. So let's not waste any time and go straight to my kitchen. So over here I have about 200 grams of paneer that I have cut in cubes. Now you can use this paneer directly into the gravy as well, but I like to season the paneer so that, you know, it's not bland in the curry. For that I'm going to season it with half a teaspoon of salt and just a quarter of a teaspoon of red chili powder, and just going to mix it up. Now I'll quickly pan fry these, some oil for the paneer. Just about 2 tablespoons should be fine. Just going to place the paneer pieces directly on to the pan this way. So that's the crust I'm talking about. So I'm just going to flip all of these now. So as you can see, the paneer is ready. I'm just going to set it aside now. Now in the same pan, I'm going to add about a tablespoon more of oil, a bay leaf, about 4 Kashmiri dried red chilies for the color, 4 green cardamoms, about 2 thin cinnamon sticks, 2 cloves or long. I'm just going to saute this for a second till you can smell the flavors. Make sure you don't burn them, so keep the flame at medium. To this I'm going to add around 2 medium roughly chopped onions, 4 roughly chopped tomatoes. I'm going to mix this up. To this I'm also going to add 12 cashews. Also going to season this with salt. Keep cooking this. And let it cook on low flame for 10 minutes. So it's been about 10 minutes. Let's see the status. As you can see, a lot of juices have released and the tomato has softened completely. Now I am going to add half a teaspoon of sugar to this just to balance out the flavors and give it one last mix. I'm turning off the gas now and I will let this cool completely. So I have transferred the mixture to a blender. I'm going to add about 3 tablespoons of water here so that it helps to combine everything together. Now I'm going to blend this till it comes to a smooth paste. So this is how it looks like after 3 minutes of continuous blending. It's a beautiful thick sauce. Now let's make the final dish. Now to the same pan I'm going to add 2 tablespoons of butter, because this is paneer butter masala. A little bit of oil, about a teaspoon, so that the butter doesn't burn. So I'm going to add a tablespoon of ginger garlic paste. I have made it fresh. Just going to saute this with the butter. It already smells divine. Now I'm going to roast some spices. First is a teaspoon of coriander powder, a teaspoon of cumin powder or jeera. For the color, I'm going to add Kashmiri red chili powder, teaspoon of garam masala. Now the heat is at low and I just have to mix this all up and cook this for 2 to 3 minutes without burning it. So the ginger garlic is cooked and its aroma has released and the masalas are also done. Now I'm going to add the onions and tomato mix to this. Look at that. Quickly give it a mix. Wow, that color is absolutely gorgeous. I'm going to add about half a cup of water and I've just scraped everything off the mixer so that nothing gets wasted. I'm going to add a quarter of a cup of fresh cream to this and give it a mix. So look at that. Wow. And our last ingredient is tablespoon of kasuri methi. Wow, just look at that. So good, right? Now I'm going to add the fried paneer to this and mix it up. So that's our paneer butter masala that looks out of this world right now. I'm just going to let this simmer for about 5 more minutes and we'll come back and serve this. Just look at that thick, luscious gravy. Oh my god. The paneer pieces have submerged, so I'm just going to put some on top. The fried paneer that I had kept, coriander on top. Just a little bit. There you go. That's my version of a delicious paneer butter masala. Let's taste now. So I'm going to dive straight into this with some paratha that I have. I'm going to dunk the paratha into the gravy. This is absolute heaven. I can taste all those whole spices, the creaminess from the butter and the cashews and the cream. It is just something else. It is one of those indulgent Indian vegetarian meals that you can make for your family at home. If you like my recipes, please subscribe to my channel. I will keep coming with such easy recipes every week. Until next time, stay safe, take care, and happy cooking.